Hello and welcome. First and foremost, here's wishing all of you a very happy Diwali. And once again, on the eve of Diwali, a big debate rages, this time over green firecrackers. First, firecrackers were banned, now a big question mark over green firecrackers as well. Should we allow, encourage our children to burst firecrackers like Sadhguru would want, or should firecrackers, no matter green or non-green, be banned? We look at that. Huge debate on the news track tonight.
Gone is India's old fireworks fervor. Mixed feelings before Dhamaka Diwali. Pollution paranoia versus selective ignorance. Sadhguru steps in, says, let the kids enjoy. As the spark dwindles in our Desi Diwali, India's cracker of a debate explodes.
On the eve of Diwali, spiritual leader Sadhguru has sparked a cracker of a debate by saying that kids must experience the fun of bursting firecrackers. Environmentalists and activists are aghast. They're saying there is no such thing as a green firecracker and that all firecrackers are polluting and therefore children must be kept miles away from firecrackers. Which side of the debate are you on?
Leader Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev reignites the cracker debate.
Let not people who are suddenly environmentally active say no child should have crackers. This is not a good way to go.
Ahead of Diwali, Sadhguru has backed allowing children to burst firecrackers. In a video message on Twitter, the spiritual leader said that concerns about air pollution shouldn't be a reason to stop kids from partaking in the joy of fireworks.
I have not lit a cracker in quite a few years, but when I was a child, how much it meant. From the month of September, we'll be dreaming crackers. And after Diwali is over, next 1-2 months, we will save the crackers and keep on doing it every day. Let not people who are suddenly environmentally active say no child should have crackers. This is not a good way to go.
He suggested that people should dump cars and walk to office for 3 days instead of making children sacrifice their fun.
All those people who are concerned about pollution in the air, in the polluting the air, you can do one thing as your sacrifice for the children so the children can enjoy. Adults can stop the crackers. And for that 3 days, you walk to your office, don't drive your car. Let children have the fun of bursting crackers.
The cracker ban has left not just spiritual world, but Bollywood divided as well. Actor Kangana Ranaut was quick to back Sadhguru on social media. The actor said Sadhguru's suggestion is a perfect answer to all Diwali environment activists. She further added that the spiritual leader had created a world record by planting millions of trees. On the other hand, Anil Kapoor's daughter and film producer Riya Kapoor opposed bursting of crackers. The Bollywood diva said bursting crackers is not only dated but grossly ignorant, inconsiderate and irresponsible. The Supreme Court has this week set aside a blanket ban on firecrackers imposed by the Calcutta High Court in West Bengal. The apex court has allowed bursting certified green crackers in areas where air quality is good or moderate. With growing air pollution and worries of climate change, the debate over faith and environment will only escalate in times to come. Bureau Report, India Today.
While festive shoppers continue to throng markets in the capital, the Kejriwal government has imposed a complete ban on crackers in Delhi, a move that's taken the cheer away from traders and shoppers alike. Wholesalers of crackers, especially in markets like Sadar Bazaar, say for them there is no Diwali without crackers.
Woo! This Diwali, Delhi's skyline will not be the same as every year. The Aam Aadmi Party government has imposed a total ban on the sale of firecrackers. The Sadar Bazaar, a wholesale market for firecrackers, now only sports a handful of shops selling pop guns and matches bombs. The ban has left traders as well as shoppers in the national capital sulking.
दिवाली का मतलब पटाखे ही होता है. हम भी छोटे होते थे तो हम भी पटाखे ही करते थे मैम. और आज की जनरेशन है बम पटाखे, बच्चों को क्या पता. फिर बच्चों के उदास चेहरे देखो कैसे हैं मैम. फेस्टिवल पे भी बच्चे उदास.
The traders claim they have suffered huge losses.
More than 13 lakh people are attached with this industry in the whole India. The Shivakasi is feeling very bad. The more than 1100 industries are working in Shivakasi. People who are attached with paper industry, with transport industry and with other small and micro industries, they all are ruined.
पिछले साल हमारे को 20 दिन का लाइसेंस मिला था. तो इन्होंने क्या किया, 12 दिन का लाइसेंस देके और 8 दिन का जिनको बैन कर दिया. वो जो माल हमारा बचा हुआ था आज भी वो मैगजीन के अंदर पड़ा हुआ माल जो है. और अब जो नया माल हमने खरीदा है वो मई और जून का खरीदा हुआ है. वो सारा हमारा मैगजीन के अंदर पड़ा हुआ है.
द डिसीजन टू बैन फायरक्रैकर्स वाज टेकन अमिड डिटीरियोरेटिंग एयर क्वालिटी इन द सिटी. फायरक्रैकर मैन्युफैक्चरर्स एंड ट्रेडर्स हैड अप्रोच्ड द हाई कोर्ट चैलेंजिंग द डिसीजन. The High Court bench upheld the government's decision.
The only crackers in the market are these small pop guns and ring pops that are for children to use. And a sea of disappointed faces here at the Sadar Bazaar as people ask around if any crackers are available. All crackers, including green crackers, have been banned this year in Delhi, leading to a muted Diwali, even as the air quality index is rapidly deteriorating.
While Delhi has banned firecrackers altogether, their sale continues in other states. For instance, in Rajasthan, where only green crackers are allowed, shopkeepers in Jaipur were seen selling all types of firecrackers.
इंडिया में 785 फैक्ट्रियां हैं जो नीरी के हिसाब से फटाके बनाती है. उन फैक्ट्रियों के लिए बारकोड जो है सन 2020 में अनिवार्य किया गया है. 2017 से ही वो ग्रीन फटाके बना रहे हैं. उनकी मैं लिस्ट आपको अप्रूव करा रहा हूँ. जो भी अभी हमारी दुकान पे माल बिक रहा है जिन कंपनियों का है वो 785 कंपनियां नीरी द्वारा अप्रूव्ड कंपनियां हैं.
क्रॉस वेरियस फायरक्रैकर शॉप्स इन पिंक सिटी कस्टमर्स आर बीइंग सोल्ड फायरक्रैकर्स इन पैकेट्स व्हिच डू नॉट हैव बारकोड्स एंड द कंज्यूमर्स डू नॉट इवन नो whether what they are purchasing are actually green firecrackers or not. With Nikhil Sharma, Devankur Vadhavan in Jaipur, India Today.
So is there merit to what Sadhguru says? Don't go away from crackers completely. Encourage children to get a sense of what it was like to burst crackers, because a lot of kids nowadays don't even know what the feeling is like. Or are environmentalists and activists right when they say that there is no such thing as a green firecracker, it's all polluting, and the more we move towards diyas, the better it is, the holier and the purer our Diwali would be. Joining me for this cracker of a debate on this broadcast, I want to welcome first TV Mohandas Pai, chairperson of Iran Capital. Vimlendu Jha joins us, well-known environmentalist. We have Rahul Ishwar, activist, joining us. He's pro-firecrackers. Gaurav Goyal joins us. He's an advocate at the Delhi High Court. He's anti-firecrackers, has worked in several cases. And Mathan Devendran joins us. He's with the Association of Tamil Nadu Firecrackers Manufacturing Association, the TANFAMA. And they're the ones who are actually manufacturing these firecrackers. Stevie Mohandas Pai, first and foremost to all of you and your families, your friends, a very, very happy Diwali. Mohandas Pai, I want to start by asking you why you think that Sadhguru has logic and rationale when he says that don't take children away from the joy of bursting firecrackers. Even if we move away from polluting firecrackers, children must experience what the whole process of bursting a firecracker is. It was part of our growing up. It must be part of our children's growing up. It must change with the times, but we mustn't move away from our history and our culture. Mohandas Pai, let's start with you.
No, I agree fully with Sadhguru for the simple reason that we are a very diverse country. We have rich traditions. We have great festivals. And festivals are occasions of joy and celebration to connect us to our past and to our culture. And bursting firecrackers on Diwali is excitement for children. I remember as a young child, I used to be excited the night before, get up in the morning, bust the crackers and see with wonder what crackers do. Sadly, in this country, fake narratives by voodoo economists, voodoo environmentalists has taken over the narrative. They misled the courts and everywhere else. There is evidence from the IIT study that crackers are not responsible for the pollution in Delhi. The Delhi pollution is a long-term thing. If you look at satellite images, there's a 3-kilometer layer of smog from Peshawar to Calcutta, which comes down in the winter and goes up in the summer and never crosses the Himalayas. It's permanently there. And the causes for that are very, very well enumerated. The causes are 1,000 million tons of coal being burnt in that entire belt for producing power. It is the Thar desert sand coming there. It is the farmers burning stubble during the season for the harvest. And it is the road dust and construction dust. They have a much bigger impact. Bursting crackers for 2 or 3 days may create some local smoke in the local areas, but they cannot impact the environment. They cannot impact pollution. You must remember that Delhi has got maybe 1,000 kilometers. If you take 1,000 cubic kilometers, that is 1 kilometer of air about Delhi, tell me who can in the right mind believe that somebody busting a few crackers is going to pollute all that and create all kind of noise. These are all fake narratives. The IIT study has very clearly demonstrated that crackers are not responsible for the pollution in Delhi. And many of them are targeting Hindu festivals like Diwali. It has gone on even in the US. They all get together, target this, put some idiotic things in the minds of our children in schools. Schools start campaign without understanding things. And I think the Supreme Court got in the fray, sadly interfering in our festivals. And the Supreme Court, in whatever wisdom is there, has said you can fire green crackers. Even that, the anarchist chief minister of Delhi is saying no. Now, I think, this is terrible. This is an assault. And what Sadhguru says is right. I want all these environmentalists to walk to office in case they care about the environment.
Vimlendu
Jha, cut down power consumption.
Sadhguru and Mohandas Pai say folks like you should walk to office, cut down your power consumption. I have this data that in the last 1 week, the number of fires, farm fires in Punjab and Haryana has shot up from 700 to 3,300 on the 3rd of November. PM2.5 levels in North India have spiked. So yes, pollution will go up, but that's happening in any case because farm fires have gone up almost fivefold. So it's not as if, obviously firecrackers will have a role to play in it, but it's not as if that's the only reason why pollution is going up, and therefore Sadhguru says don't deprive children of the joy of bursting some crackers. Vimlendu Jha.
Rahul, first of all, nobody's saying that, all the pollution that we have in North India is because of firecrackers. You and I have done multiple shows talking about many other factors. But what Supreme Court talked about, or what many environmentalists and myself, we talk about, and all the doctors, not the voodoo and wuda that Mohandas Pai was talking about, is the doctors of our country who actually said that it's bad, bursting firecrackers is bad for human lungs and bad for pregnant women and children. Please also understand the kids and their joy that Sadhguru is talking about, or Mohandas Pai, the tradition that he's talking about. It's three children who actually filed a case in the Supreme Court, a petition in the Supreme Court that actually got a ban on firecrackers. If your air quality index hits almost 20 times worse than permissible limits, yes, ha ha ha, Mohandas Pai, I thought you worked in a tech company and you understood data and it was common sense. Deepavali is not festival. Deepavali is not festival.
It's all rigged cases.
Deepavali is
don't,
not.
Don't lie to us on television by saying children find the cases.
Let's not crosstalk, sir. Sir, you finished your thing.
Stop lying, man.
Finish. I'm saying that if air quality index hits, I'm not lying. This is the scientific result. These are doctors, not
someone. It's not a scientific result. See the IIT study.
Deepavali is the festival of lights. When did it become a thing of sodium and potassium and magnesium and everything else? 30 years ago, I used to jump in Yamuna.
Read your history. Read your history.
2 years ago,
you could stop practice.
There is COVID appropriate behavior, therefore pollution protocol behavior. Sir, please understand one thing. This is stupidity that you're talking about. You guys bring faith when children are dying.
Man, you are so stupid. You went after C.C. Ravi Shankar and did the same Hindu environmentalism. Remember, same fake
what
narrative.
What would environment if he actually damaged my Yamuna,
children
if firecrackers...
Toddlers go to Supreme Court. That's rubbish, man. They can't even think.
Ask children, why are you on the show? Ask children whether they suffer or not. Is it a matter of joy? The question of
child,
health, public health, pollution on that one particular day.
Children, bus crackers, they don't suffer.
Children are the ones who filed the case, sir. Children are the ones who actually filed that PIL that actually got a ban on firecrackers.
You provoke a small minor who can't think.
Children can't think. Why are you thinking? Why are you being a child? What you did 40 years ago, Mohandas Pai. As in, if you have become a lobbyist of a particular kind, where
rubbish.
Everything threatens
what are
your
a
faith,
of the
sorry,
of the
you know,
leftist?
That faith gave Sati also a right. No, I'm a lobbyist for the environment. What are you lobbying for? I lobby for clean air. What do you lobby for?
What do
you lobby
case?
For?
All fake narratives.
Yes,
right,
I am a
things.
Lobbyist. I lobby for clean air and better
yeah,
health.
Yeah, I know. You're paid off by others. You're paid off by people.
Ask Rahul, is it easy to breathe on Diwali day, Rahul? You tell me. Ask any child.
You're all
is it easy to breathe?
Are
hospitals
years.
Filled with patients or not?
Okay, Rahul Ishwar, is
ask
it then
doctors?
Down... To
ask
choice,
hospitals.
Should politicians, netas, chief ministers decide for the people, or as Sadhguru says, let people decide for themselves, and
Rahul
if possible, let's allow at least green firecrackers rather than this complete ban. Rahul Ishwar.
Rahul Kawalji, three humble submissions. If anybody suspects that there are people behind those children who went to Supreme Court, can we blame them? Don't we all know the difficulty to get a case filed in Supreme Court? Don't we all know the charges that we have to pay exorbitantly to the advocates to get a file, something filed in Supreme Court? I'm a person who is fighting in Supreme Court for Shabarimala for the past 15 years, so I know the difficulty. So if some small children are going to file a case, we can definitely know that there are many people who are behind them and they may have motivations. Second, nobody disrespect environmental activism, but we are only saying cultural activism and cultural vibrancy is also as much as a part of our system along with all the other aspects. So culture needs to be preserved, and there are some ways that brings us joy. See, whenever a Hindu festival happens, they call for colorless Holi, they call for milkless Shivaratri, they call for Jallikattu-less or Shabarimala-less. Everything regarding Sanatana Dharma and our cultural practices are always being questioned in the name of progressivism, environmentalism, animal activism. So suddenly we as dharmics, and we believe in every positivity of religion, we suddenly feel we are being sidelined, questioned, and the pseudo-progressive narratives are being taken over. There is no disrespect to environmental activism, but at the same point of time, when a great person like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is doing a culture festival, all the environmental activists come. So please remember, it is not culture versus environment. It is culture plus the environment. See, Diwali comes only once in a year. Well, let our children have some joy. That's the spirit of what Sadhguru says. That's the spirit of what Mohandas Pai Sar says. Why can't you appreciate cultural sensitivity to every nation? For example, tomorrow if you go to Spain, will you tell, let us stop all the bullfight? If you go to Spain, are you going to tell, let us stop all this bullfight? It is integral part of their culture. Similarly, Ganesh also and Ganesha Visarjan is a part of our culture. Durga Puja is a part of our culture. Or every faith has their own culture. So let us protect. And it's a constitutional mandate too. Article 25 and 26 gives us right to uphold our culture, our faith in a very positive way. If there are suggestions, please feel free to give. But at the same point of time, purposeful targeting of Hindu community festival in any name is unfortunate. That's very wrong from our progressive and liberal friends to say. If they have suggestions, they are definitely welcome. But at the same point of time, they should not be piggybacking on things to fire from the shoulders of different things because they don't like our Indian cultural aspect.
Gaurav Goyal,
very unfortunate.
We're seeing Rahul Ishwar as also Mohandas Pai make this about culture, saying that let it be about choice. If you don't want your child or your child doesn't want to bus crackers, that's fine. But if Mohandas Pai's family or if Rahul Ishwar's family want to bus crackers, it should be their right, and that right should not be taken away from them, and we shouldn't have chief ministers and politicians deciding for people what they should do. It's a cultural issue.
See, it's not a cultural issue. We cannot just, you know, come back to that everything is religion, that we're, you know, targeting the Hindu religion. The ban by the Delhi government or by the Supreme Court is synonymous. It is across the board. It's for every festivity, and it should be upheld for every festivity. No one is targeting the Hindu religion or the culture. And, you know, when Mr. Mohandas said that, you know, we should allow, when Sadhguru said we should allow the children to enjoy the, you know, the joy of bursting crackers, we should realize that we can always change the conditioning of our own children at the end of the day. When pollution increases subsequently after the Diwali dust settles down, then does the increase in death, does that choose religion as to who's Hindu or who's Muslim, or does just one religion or one culture people die? So this is atrocious to make such comments. You know, everyone's targeting. This debate of not bursting crackers has been going on for a while. The Supreme Court has passed a very well-reasoned order by saying that these kind of salt should not be used, this kind of salt should be used, and they've struck a balance amongst the community, amongst the manufacturers also, so that no one eventually gets hurt. So if green crackers are allowed in some states, and we know that once the paddy burning or the stubble burning will start or anything will start, the ambient air quality in Delhi will deteriorate. So okay, we have to
let Mohandas Pai respond to this, because that data that I have on my screen shows that the number of farm fires has gone up 5 times just in the last 1 week. So there's already, and you understand data and statistics well, there's already a base effect where you've seen the base go up. Now on top of this, there's a sudden spike on account of firecrackers. Pollution will shoot through the roof and people in North India and elsewhere will choke. And therefore, the likes of Gaurav Goyal making the argument that it exacerbates an already bad situation.
Rahul, let us go with data and evidence as people of reason. All right? For the last 50, 100 years, we've been busting crackers. We have not had this issue. This issue has escalated primarily because of other reasons, burning of coal, smog, this, you know, burning of agriculture residue, etc. And the air has gone bad. It's not because of crackers. Now, I am all for laying down new standards for crackers to make sure that the excess of the cracker industry goes away, that they don't pollute beyond a certain point, that something is acceptable. The green cracker idea to be expanded is good. But why say do it for 2 hours in the morning, 2 hours in the evening? Okay, you set a new standard, say the cracker should not have so much of, you know, burning, so much of material, that is fine. Let there be crackers, let us bust crackers during the 2-3 days, give us the full freedom, don't interfere. Set standards, that is fine, let us have good standards. But to blame crackers, to say we should not have crackers, burn only diyas, like the judgment of the Calcutta High Court, that is absurd. Because let us go by data and evidence. How much of the pollution is because of crackers? How much of it is accelerated? Let's go by the evidence. And the evidence from the IIT study is very clear. Yes, on the 2 days, I think there's one study which says, on the 2 days, there's no reasonable evidence to say it has shot up beyond a great limit all across Delhi. It may be in a few areas in Delhi, not all across Delhi. That's why I said Delhi has got 1,000 square cubic kilometers of air. It doesn't get polluted so much. Reasons are, let's be reasonable people, set new standards and give the freedom to
Vimlendu
people. That is much better.
Mohandas Pai makes the argument, instead of banning firecrackers completely, set standards. Let there be clear definitions, as have attempts have been made to lay out, of what a green firecracker is. Push the manufacturers towards green firecrackers rather than a total ban on any kind of firecracker, saying that that's not the right approach.
Okay, sir, let me interrupt here, and I'd like to tell that.
Rahul, I agree, and that's what the Supreme Court has actually done. That's exactly what the Supreme Court has done. Supreme Court said only green firecrackers. But all, at the same time, in the same breath, I should also tell you that it's actually, when you talk about green firecrackers, what are green firecrackers? 20% less polluting. You know, we could all afford to burst firecrackers, put our house on fire, do many, many other things, theatrics around things, if our air was good. 50 years ago, our air was good. I could drink straight from the river. Now I can't drink straight from the river. I have changed my culture. Sati was good. You know, Vad Vyavastha was good. We all adapt to situations.
How old are you, Vimlendu?
I can shake hands with you.
Vimlendu, right now, how old are you?
COVID appropriate behavior.
Vimlendu, how old are you?
I'm 41.
So when you're saying 50 years ago, you could drink water from the river. That's a bit of an Atishokti Alankar there.
You understand what I'm trying to say, right?
So I want to show
what you did 50 years ago or 100 years ago doesn't really matter, right?
I want to show our viewers this ground report from Sivakasi, which is in Tamil Nadu and is India's firecracker manufacturing haven, which is staring at a very dark Diwali. cracker manufacturers are devastated as many states have announced a ban which they weren't anticipating because they thought, okay, green firecrackers at least allowed. Now states like the capital have banned that. And Akshaya Nath went to Sivakasi to file this ground report.
Once a thriving place for firecracker manufacturers, this city of Sivakasi in Tamil Nadu's Viruddhunagar district is facing serious economic crisis. Sivakasi has over 6.5 lakh families directly and indirectly dependent on the firecracker industry for their livelihood. Cracker manufacturers claim that at least 40% of firecracker industry will shut down permanently if sales don't pick up this Diwali.
The three states that have banned it have done it purely on unreasonable level. They said they are quoting the pandemic. I don't think there's any scientific data to correlate fireworks to COVID. Will the chief minister stand up and say, I'm going to ban the first reason for pollution? So we are a small trade. So he's used his chap and he's finished us off. Game.
Manufacturers called the ban on crackers unreasonable, claiming Sivakasi was producing one of the cleanest crackers in the world.
இப்போ இந்த தீபாவளிங்கிறது இந்த பட்டாசு வெடிக்கிறதுங்கிறதே ஒரு ட்ரெடிஷ்னல் ஒரு கல்ச்சரல் ஈவெண்ட்டு ஒரு 7 ஸ்டேட்டில் பேன் பண்ணியிருந்தாங்க அதனால் வந்து எங்ககிட்ட அவங்க சரக்கு ஆர்டர்ஸ் கொடுக்கல அதனால் நாங்கள் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பண்ணி என்ன செய்ய முடியும் அதனால் நிச்சயமாக எங்களுடைய ப்ரொடக்ஷன் 50% தான் ப்ராஃபிட் மார்ஜின்லாம் எங்களுக்குலாம் இப்போ ரொம்ப வந்து அடிபடுது இந்த வருஷத்தை பொறுத்தவரை கொஞ்சம் ரொம்ப இதாக இருக்கும் ஏன்னா ரா மெட்டீரியல் காஸ்ட்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 40% கூடிடுச்சு
Families depending on the industry are devastated. They say if government does not step in time, Sivakasi will be wiped out.
அது பிறகு வேற தொழில் செய்யறதுக்கு பட்டாசு தொழில் தவிர வேற எதுவுமே இல்லை செக்கு 50,000 ஓனர் தான் கொடுத்தாரு ஆனால் கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து இது வரைக்கும் எந்த உதவியும் பண்ணலை ஆனால் எழுதிட்டு போனாங்க எந்த உதவியும் செய்யலை
It is not going to be a happy Diwali for them, but they're hoping that at least somewhere else, somebody will be enjoying their Diwali with these crackers and having a sparkling one. But the big question still remains as to what will happen to the livelihood of the people in this cracker industry who say that there is no other alternative as a livelihood in Sivakasi, the town that they hail from. With camera person Daniel from Sivakasi, this is Akshaya Nath for India Today.
We have Mathan Devendran with us. He's the Firecrackers Manufacturers Association representative. Mr. Devendran, is there anything called a green firecracker in your view? Are you pivoting towards that? Would you push for green firecrackers? Many activists who've been pinging me through the day when they knew we were doing the show saying there's nothing called a green firecracker. It's only marginally less polluting.
So actually green firecrackers, according to the Supreme Court, or any firecracker which reduce less than 30% emissions can compare to the conventional fireworks or called green firecrackers. These are the standards set by the Supreme Court. And this is the standard being followed by the industry now, according to the formulations and the additives given by CSI NIRI, which is the topmost body which controls the pollution. NIRI is the topmost which controls anything related to this environment is controlled by that body. So all these formulations are given by it, all the certificates are given by it. So how can they say there is no green fireworks now when we have a central government's body, the top body giving a certificate and formulations according to the Supreme Court? How can people like this so-called environment activists say there is nothing called green fireworks? Then it is contempt of the court. They are saying they are contempt of the court if they say there is no green fireworks. And let me tell you one thing, sir. Fireworks is less than 0.1 contributor to the pollution in a given year. And even so, we are ready to change. And what about the balance 99.9%? What are the other actions they have been taken for the other things? This is, we are again saying this is an one-day affair, two-day affair, and the pollution levels are back to normal after the 48 hours. Delhi is like a vacuum chamber and there is no air movement, and that is what causing a huge misconception that fireworks is the reason in Delhi. It's not like that. You said that the stubble burning has gone up to 5 times.
Gaurav Goyal, the likes of Mathan Devendran would say that the owners unfairly and disproportionately gets placed on the firecracker manufacturers, that there is a year-long problem. Politicians, instead of trying to fix everything else that they need to fix, pin the blame on the firecrackers to make it seem as if these firecrackers are to blame and therefore go in for sweeping decisions like the ones that we're seeing.
See, you know, what the Supreme Court has very clearly said, they've set a procedure, as Mr. Mohandas was saying, you know, we should set up a procedure or there should be policies about this. So when he said that, you know, the coal burning, which produces power, creates more pollution, what do you want? You want the houses to go dark in India? What do you want? Like, there's no solution to that. That might be necessary.
There's a solution.
They're trying to shift the narrative. So there is a solution, but you cannot have solar power energy for everything, right? So we'll eventually get
there. No, it's not solar power. I will explain
right
to you, my friend.
Right now,
I will explain to you.
And the
I will explain to you there's a solution.
Sir, the IIT, sir, let me complete. I did not interject. The IIT Kanpur study you're referring to was rightly rejected by the Honorable Supreme Court. Are you against that judgment also? If that is, see, if that is the case, then cross studies will always be there when such a controversy arises or such an issue arises. But no one's saying that they're targeting the, you know, firecracker burning association or the manufacturers in this way. The green crackers have been permitted. If they do not have any problem in manufacturing the green crackers, some states are allowing the bursting of green crackers, go ahead and produce that. Eventually, a balance has to be maintained, and we cannot just refer to Article 25 and 26, and Article 21 also, the Indian Constitution also needs to step in. It's the right to life. If you want to burn crackers, then are you willing to give up power in your house? Are you willing to walk to the offices, as Sadhguru said? Do that. Let the policy change come in, but that is not practical. We cannot have two different policies for the same set of population or the same citizens of one country. It needs to be unanimous.
Rahul Ishwar wants to come in. This whole issue of green firecrackers only being 30% better, Rahul. They're still polluting. A lot of activists, as I said, pinging to say it's only marginally better. They are still bad.
Rahulji, you know, absolutely, a balance has to be
done. Saying, and he has data. Can he show some data that 5x the cost of pollution in Delhi? Can he show
exactly
some scientific
that's
data?
And fireworks, what percentage?
Can you show any survey that 5x the cost?
Data? There's a WHO study that talks about 20 times worse. There are many scientific studies. If you open your eyes beyond faith and understand that this is not about this, it's about children and their health.
Sir, you please show the data.
There is data. I will show you the data. I will show the data from WHO to all the medical fraternity. There's enough data to show that Delhi's air becomes really bad.
Medical committee submitted a report. They said that the significance of using 5x is marginal. It is a Maulana Azad medical report they have submitted in the Supreme Court. It is saying that because of fireworks, it is very insignificant. We have the word and
sir,
we have given
Supreme
a document
Court from 2005 till now.
Everyone respects
so without having
picture,
any scientific data and proof from any survey or whatever, you cannot say that pollution, that doctor is saying, this doctor is saying. Who is the doctor saying, sir? You have to get a survey done by central government agency. Get a survey done by the central government agency.
Please remember, we shouldn't be blind and one-sided in a debate like this. Just one submission. We shouldn't be blind and one-sided in a debate like this. There are cultural realities. There are environmental concerns. There should be a handshake. There should be a consensus. But many times what happens from environmental activities, activists is that they take a totally one-sided position. See, we all respect environment. But don't go for one-sided propaganda. For example, my child who is studying in a school, the teacher today morning in the class told, don't crack these kind of firecrackers and don't use firecrackers and celebrate Diwali differently. So I interjected and said, this is not right. This is not for you to say. You know, this is not for you to instruct in a particular way. So please remember this extreme imposition of one-sided narrative by our left liberal friends is counterproductive, is not good, whereas we should try for a consensus respecting the cultural sensitivities and environmental concerns. But that they are not ready to accept. They are going only for a one-sided bashing of the cultural practice, and that is only going to be counterproductive.
Vimlendu Jha wants to come in, being accused of being one-sided, blinded by hate and anti-culture.
Sir, the toddler who filed this case.
Okay, so Vimlendu. Rahul, every time, you know, in this, we discuss air pollution through the year, and only now is when we discuss firecrackers. Other than that, you and I, and throughout the year, we discuss other causes of air pollution. I don't understand that. Why does it actually take, you know, a shade of culture and faith as if we, when we fight for our better environment and better air for Hindus and Muslims and Christians and all the children, why does it become a matter of faith? It's not about faith. Anything in the name of culture that is damaging needs to really be let go of. You know, Diwali is a festival of diyas, not a festival of fire and asthma and powder and mercury. For heaven's sake, just because 50 years and 100 years you've done it, we can't do it. Anything that was stupid in our culture, which actually was at the cost of our health, human health, we stopped it. We shut down all the temples because of COVID. Was it stupid? No, it was intelligent. You need to take some extreme measures so as to protect yourself. Do you think Narendra Modi was anti-Hindu if he shut all the temples during COVID? No.
So you cannot compare apples and pineapples. That's an unfair comparison. Apples and pineapples, if you compare and
it's
say
both taste alike, it's not apples and pineapples.
Both.
Ask a child on the road.
Remember, there's a difference. There's a difference. Sir. And we all respect that sentiment. But having said that, there are cultural needs, cultural requirements, communities and crores of people waiting for Diwali being one of the largest celebrations. So you have to strike a balance. This one-sided narrative of demeaning by saying we should put our house on fire or asthma, associating all the negative things with Diwali is not going to be good. Diwali is a sacred occasion. Diwali is for Diya, Diwali is for crackers.
Ask the honest resident of Delhi what he or she feels on the morning of Diwali.
Okay, Mohandas Pai, I'm out of time. Final quick comments before I end. Mr. Pai.
Rahul, look at the intolerance of these fundamentalists. The Supreme Court has said we love green crackers. They have set the standard, but they don't even want to have green crackers. And they said question in the Supreme Court. So the courts don't give a decision in the way these fundamentalists want. They question everything. These are the kind of fake narratives that they run. Let us say we have to respect cultural practices. Let us set standards so that we can bust our crackers and don't impinge on our freedom. Let us set new standards. So, for example, in coal, if you have electrostatic precipitators and reduce the ash content, you can reduce the pollution substantially. You don't have to turn off the lights. There are solutions which we have to work at. It's not about solar power alone. There are solutions. And let us not rubbish the technology studies of IIT. They are the experts. They know the data, not the Supreme Court.
Vimalendu, 15 seconds before I wrap up. Vimalendu.
Rahul, it's about the idea is about health. It's about people's health. It's the health of the children. In COVID times, you know, in any sane society, we would not be even discussing this. When, you know, half of our country is battling, we've gone through tough COVID time, COVID hits your respiratory system. Yes, rubbish. It's rubbish like what you people like you peddle, because which we are actually having a debate. There's a law of land that says it's bad.
Don't compare oranges with onions and all that. Don't know all that, okay? This is the kind of fake narrative people run. Like you did for CC,
Ravi Shankar's study that COVID is related to fireworks. Do you have a scientific study?
So Supreme Court.
Okay. So this is a deeply divisive and polarizing debate. On the eve of Diwali, I don't want to take sides. You've heard different points of view. We leave it to you to decide whether individuals should take this decision, whether the state should take a decision, whether courts should take a decision, and whether you're comfortable with the idea of green firecrackers or not, and what can be done to make these green firecrackers greener. Well, green or not, firecrackers or not, here's wishing all of you a very happy Deepavali, and thank you so much for joining us. Mohandas Pai, Vimalendu Jha, Matan Devendran, Gaurav Goyal, Rahul Ishwar, I think this debate has shown, as is very often the case, that you know we believe in the power of a debate. Whether there is agreement or not, at least there's a cracking debate, and then we leave it to you, our viewers, to decide where you stand on this topic. I'm slipping into a break. For Prime Minister Modi, Kedarnath holds a special place in his heart. So every time the Prime Minister makes a pilgrimage to the holy site, there is no effort spared to spruce up the area in the build-up to his visit. Each of the Prime Minister's visits have been unique. If the last time he spent a solitary night in a cave, this time he will be there right after Deepavali to oversee and inaugurate a slew of new developments that are taking place around the Kedarnath Dham. This is a report by Chitra Tripathi, who went to Kedarnath right ahead of the Prime Minister's visit.
Kedar Puri is getting all digged up. The Prime Minister is coming.
Pradhan Mantri ji ne pichle varson mein ek bahut bada infrastructure ka kaam is Kedar Puri mein kiya hai. Aap dekhenge kitna choda ek corridor jahan hazaron log khade ho sakte hain. Shankaracharya Bhagwan ki pratima ka anavaran hona hai. Aap dekhenge udhar sare pandon ke sare makanon ka punarnirman ho raha hai. आप देखेंगे आस्था पथ अलग से तैयार हो रहा है। तो कुल मिलाकर एक बहुत बड़ा जो उनकी एक आस्था थी, जो उनका एक भगवान केदार के प्रति लगाव था, वो सारा यहाँ नजर आ रहा है।
Prime Minister Modi will be offering prayers at the Kedarnath temple. He will inaugurate the Samadhi of Sri Adi Shankaracharya that was damaged in the 2013 deluge. He will also unveil a statue of the Shankaracharya.
ये जो आदि शंकराचार्य जी की यहाँ पर समाधि थी और एक धर्मदंड वहाँ पर एक स्थापित किया गया था, क्योंकि आपदा के समय वो क्षतिग्रस्त हो गया, तो वहाँ पर आदि गुरु शंकराचार्य की एक विशाल प्रतिमा वहाँ पर स्थापित की गई, जिसका वजन 28 टन है। और ये मैसूर के पास ये इस प्रतिमा को बनाया गया है, और बहुत जीवंत है। कृष्ण शिला जो ग्रेनाइट जैसी मजबूत होती है, और एक दक्षिण की जैसी परंपरा है कि वहाँ पर जो प्रतिमाएं बनती हैं वो इसी कृष्ण शिला से बनती हैं, तो उसी कृष्ण शिला से इस प्रतिमा को बनाया गया है आदिगुरु शंकराचार्य जी की, जो लगभग 12 फुट ऊंची है और 28 टन इसका वेट है।
इट इज स्टनिंग, दे हैव कैप्चर्ड द इक्विनिमिटी ऑफ आदि शंकरा एंड आल्सो द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ आदि शंकरा। ही ट्रैवल्ड अक्रॉस इंडिया 4 टाइम्स बिफोर ही डाइड एट द एज ऑफ 32। सो मोस्ट स्टैचूज जस्ट कीप ओनली हिज कामनेस, बट दिस ब्रिंग्स बोथ ऑफ दिस, बोथ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ इट, एंड इट्स रियली ब्यूटीफुल।
शुरू में हमने रामबाड़ा से केदारनाथ तक रास्ते का निर्माण किया है, उसके बाद केदारनाथ में 2 हेलीपैड और लिंचौली में 1 हेलीपैड का निर्माण किया है, और केदारनाथ में 40 तीर्थ पुरोहितों के घरों का निर्माण किया गया है, और यहाँ पर 3 पुल हमने बनाए हैं, और जो मंदिर के सामने जो रास्ता है उसका निर्माण किया गया है, और सरस्वती नदी की तरफ यहाँ पर रास्ते का निर्माण किया गया है, और अभी मंदाकिनी नदी की तरफ रास्ते का निर्माण चल रहा है और घाटों का निर्माण चल रहा है।
Prime Minister Modi will lay the foundation stone for multiple projects worth over 180 crore rupees. These include the redevelopment of Sangam Ghat, first aid and tourist facilitation center, admin office and hospital, 2 guest houses, police station, command and control center, Mandakini Astapath queue management and rain shelter, and Saraswati civic amenity building. The Prime Minister will also review and inspect the work already done and are still in process along the Saraswati Astha Path. There are few other projects that the Prime Minister is scheduled to inaugurate. In the list are key infrastructure projects which have been completed, like the Saraswati Retaining Wall Astha Path and Ghats, Mandakini Retaining Wall Astha Path, Tirth Purohit Houses and Garud Chatti Bridge on River Mandakini.
जो 2013 के बाद यहाँ पे पहले से बहुत अच्छी व्यवस्था स्थापित कर दी गई है, हमारे जो माननीय प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी हैं उनके मार्गदर्शन में यहाँ पे पहले से बहुत ही अच्छा जो व्यवस्था है यहाँ पे दिखाई दे रही है, और सभी यात्रु यहाँ पर आकर बहुत ही प्रसन्न हैं, अति प्रसन्न हैं।
देखिए, मैं लगातार 2011 से यहाँ पे बाबा केदार की यात्रा कर रहा हूँ। 2013 में जो आपदा आई थी उसके एक दो साल तक काफ़ी तहस नहस यहाँ पे हो गया था, लोगों का रोज़गार छिन गया था, लेकिन आज के समय में लोगों को काफ़ी अच्छा रोज़गार यहाँ पे मिल रहा है, और काफ़ी अच्छा यहाँ पे कार्य जो हो रहा है शासन प्रशासन की तरफ से, बहुत अच्छा कार्य हो रहा है।
प्रोटोकॉल के अनुसार और सिक्योरिटी मेजर्स के अनुसार सारी तैयारियाँ, बैरिकेडिंग इत्यादि इत्यादि सब करी जा रही है।
The BJP has invited sadhus and devotees to be part of the nationwide celebrations on 5th November to be held at 4 dhams, 12 jyotirlings and 86 prominent temples established across the country by Adi Shankaracharya during his travels.
माना जाता है कि पांडवों ने यहाँ पर इस मंदिर का निर्माण करवाया था, उसके बाद इसको पुनर्जीवित करने का काम किया था आदि गुरु शंकराचार्य ने। तब से लेकर अब तक ये मंदिर यूं ही यहाँ पर डटा है, खड़ा है, और दूर दूर से भक्तजन यहाँ पर आते हैं। लेकिन 2013 उस साल की आई प्राकृतिक आपदा ने यहाँ पर सब कुछ तहस नहस कर दिया था, सब कुछ बिखर सा गया था, लेकिन एक बार फिर से मूर्त रूप में ये हिस्सा कर रहा है बाबा भोले के भक्तों का स्वागत, और पूरी तरह से इसकी रौनक भी इस मंदिर की भव्यता और यहाँ की शालीनता, इसकी कुशलता को देख कर आप समझ सकते हैं।
He is wishing all of you a very, very happy Diwali. Stay safe, whether you burst crackers or not. Have fun and lots of love, peace, prosperity and good health. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.